Hello, today I am going to show you how you can deploy Julia Dash web application on Docker. So let's get started. First question is, what is Docker? Docker is an application just like you use Chrome, Facebook, Adobe, Photoshop in your operating system, right? But it is a lightweight and utilize better memory than the VirtualBox. Like any other application you install, you also need to install it. So how you can install Docker? Open your browser, Chrome or Mozilla Firefox, and type here docker.com. And here you can find documentation of installing the Docker. Before moving forward, let's look how we run Julia app or any application. And as you can see that I have installed operating system Ubuntu, and the application like Chrome, Julia, plus dash libraries, because I am showing you the dash web application, so that's why I need a dash libraries. It is very obvious. This is my operating system, as you can see, and these are apps are default come when you are installing the Ubuntu operating system, okay? And there are tons of application you can find. And here is I already installed Julia, and I also already installed the packages like dash dash core component. So and here this is a folder where I write a application. So this is a app.gl file. I open and show you what is it. So I am using here this library, and just focus here, I am making three component here: header file and the division and some graphs, and then I finally run the server in IP address 0.0, basically localhost and debug true. So by default it run on the port 8050. Let's look how you can run your app. So first type here Julia and file name app.gl. server Julia server is running. So what I am doing now, I just calling the I just sending the HTTP request. So my IP address is 0.0.0.0, port number 8050. This is my dash web application. To stop the server, press Ctrl C. Same thing we do in Docker. It is just like a virtual box. If you ever use virtual box, what you generally do in virtual box, you install any operating system and just use like a Windows or Mac. For any application, first you need a operating system, right? So first I have to install also in Docker operating system. For that I am using here Ubuntu operating system. To do that, I need a Docker file. This is my Docker file, as you can see. Just type here from and Ubuntu, this is a tag, latest, and save it. To build the Docker image, type here sudo. So I am typing here sudo because you can become an administration and you don't need to write a sudo, but I am okay with that for writing sudo. So sudo docker minus t for tag and your image name, new image name. I am writing here my Ubuntu, and tag I am giving 16, and I am typing here dot because I am typing here dot because I am in current directory, that's why I am typing here dot. To see the images, type sudo docker. As you can see that my Ubuntu image is build 16.0. You install Ubuntu operating system in Docker, and now I am showing you how you can run any image. For run the image, you have to type docker run, and one thing keeps in your mind: whenever you run the Docker, it creates a object container, okay? So object is you can imagine container is just like a object, and image is just like a class. Then you exit again you run the Docker, it create a new object, okay, of the same class. So like that it run. To run the Docker, type sudo docker run minus it for interactive repl and your image name. So I am typing here my Ubuntu, then tag name 16.0. Now I am inside in my Docker image Ubuntu. So if you see my Ubuntu operating system, if I type here, this is my Ubuntu operating system and this is a Ubuntu operating system inside the Docker. So let's see what is the difference. By default Python is come, Python 3 is by default installed in the Ubuntu, as you know, and there are lots of application already installed by comes by default. So like Gedit, okay, and Chrome browser and vi editor. So this is a vi editor, as you can see, this is a vi editor. But whenever I type here like Python 3, so it gives error, not error, but it is not installed in the, if I type here vi. So what is the difference between the Ubuntu image on the Docker and you generally use your simple operating system, whether is Windows, Mac or any Ubuntu operating system? So all the images or operating system you find in the Docker, it is specifically built to deployment your application, okay, not for using a normal use. But still you can run some basic command like bash script like echo hello world. So there are lots of things you can do. To exit the, press Ctrl D and it automatically stop. To see the how many Docker container is running, type here sudo docker. So there is no container is running because whenever I exit the from the Ubuntu, it automatically stop. To see the all the container, type here sudo docker ps minus a. So this is a container I recently. Now let's check. Now I again run the image. So sudo docker, now I again run the, now I exit again. If I type now, I see the total number of container sudo docker ps minus a. So as you can see that there are two object is created. As I said you that whenever you run the Docker image, it will create a new object of the same class. To remove the Docker container, type here sudo docker rm or your container ID. So it will remove the container. So likewise, there are lots of command in Docker you can learn from the website. Till now you know some basic command to handle images and container, that's enough. So you got operating system Ubuntu right in the Docker. Let's install Julia because we want to run the dash web application Julia. So that's why I'm need. To get the application Julia, you have to use the run command. So run command basically used to build the image. When you run this command, what happens that it installed the Julia in the operating system. But what is the special things about Docker is that, like Ubuntu, as you saw earlier, Ubuntu is already you download from the server. Likewise, Ubuntu image is already built by somebody, Ubuntu company, and likewise Julia image is also built by somebody. You don't need to rebuild it. Come here hub.docker.com. Here from here all the images like Ubuntu operating system, Windows or any images, Docker will Docker install. So I need a Julia image. So I type here Julia. So I can find the first image, so which is official image from the Julia open source community. So I can use it. So you can use a Docker pull. You can directly pull or you can build. Like I built this image. I had seen you that this is a Docker file and I write here Ubuntu latest. This command, what it do, it create a copy of Ubuntu. This is my image, my Ubuntu. So my Ubuntu is just a photocopy of Ubuntu latest, which is present in the server, Docker Hub server. Whenever you type Docker pull Ubuntu latest, so what it do, it install the image which have a name Ubuntu. So whenever you write from Ubuntu, what it do, it create a photocopy of this. So my Ubuntu is also a Ubuntu. Ubuntu is itself is a Ubuntu. This is my Docker file and I write here from Julia. So what it do, it create a image, photocopy image of Julia image, and I installed Ubuntu Julia. Now what I need, dash, because I want to run the dash applications. Like Julia image is already built by somebody, and you can search in the Docker Hub, is it already built by somebody or not. I don't think it is built. So for you have to build by yourself. When this command is execute, what it do, it download the dash in the Julia. Till now we reached here. Now let's master and see what is left. As you can see that file is missing, if you observed. And now you have to do what you can do. You can send this file to the Docker Ubuntu operating system. For that, type here command, copy command. You have to use for that copy command. Now only Chrome is left. I can't send any GUI app on the Docker. Now let's look the CMD command, which is very necessary. This is my new Docker file where I install the Ubuntu operating system. Then I write CMD. Whatever you see forward to the CMD, what mean by that is that it execute whenever you run the Docker. For example, so I already built the this file, Docker file, and I just show you how when I run sudo docker. As I run the Docker, this Docker image 0, which has a tag number 0.1, it print the hello world. Why it print hello world? Because in this Docker file, I write whenever the Docker container is run, CMD run this command. So echo hello world. That's why it print the hello world. Similarly, to run your dash application, you have to type Julia and your app file. In the Docker file, you write CMD and Julia your file name. But here is the problem. It run inside the Docker. We cannot access this app. You can imagine Docker is just like a locker room, and whatever app is running inside the Docker, you cannot access. So it is not accessible to the outside world. To access from the outside world, you have to tell the Docker. You have to use the keyword expose and the port number. So expose and type here the port number. This means that you are telling the Docker to run the app in this port and connect with the outside world. That's it. And of course, Docker itself is a application, so you also need a port number of Docker application also. So I am running my application on the port number 8050, and also my Docker application also running on the 8050. If you know about the operating system, each application have a own port number. So I cannot run two application on the same port. But here my application inside the Docker, so you can, this is totally the new different world. So that's why you can run on the same port. Now you can access by your web browser. So you send the request to the Docker port number and it talk with the your application. And it responds to your Docker application, and then finally the Docker will reply to you. This is my Docker file image. So this is Julia, and I am installing these packages, and I copy this and I expose the application in 8050 port and I just run it. Now what I am doing now, I just build it. It successfully built. Now let's look the images. So sudo docker images. So as you can see that JL-90.0 tag is successfully built. Now I am running it. So sudo docker run IT interactive. I want to run this container at the background. That's why I am writing here -d. And port number. Type here Docker, your Docker port number, so 8050. Now type here the port number where your app is running, so 8050 also. So 8050. Then finally type your image name, so JL-. My container is running, so now let's look. First type here IP address, then port number 8050. So my app is running 8050. So as you can see that I successfully send the HTTP request and response to me. In the end, I stop this Docker. So sudo docker container is successfully stopped. Now refresh this. So this will not work because I stopped the container. Thank you to see my video.